Hey everyone, welcome back to White Sparrow Living, Luke 12:6. This is Wendy. Top of the morning to ya! Today we're going to be doing five Dollar Tree Buffalo Check DIYs for St. Patrick's Day. And then at the end we're going to have our prayer post. So to start with, we're going to make this sign with little shamrocks out of Buffalo Check. So I started with a frame, an 8x10. If you can find something that starts in white, that would be easier. This green Buffalo Check scarf, some foam shamrocks, they come in a pack of 12, and you'll find that in the St. Patrick's Day aisle. Some random paper, this is just regular paper that has kind of a ticking pattern on it. Some burlap ribbon, three of these push pins that have the black beads on top. Some Waverly chalk paint in white and elephant. Some matte finish Mod Podge with some makeup sponges to apply it. And then some tumbling tower blocks. And I have to tell you guys, I'm so excited. I received my very first piece of friend mail, and it was from my sweet viewer, Michelle Meacham in Colton, Ohio. Thank you so much, Michelle. This was really exciting for me. And she had heard me say that my Dollar Tree didn't ever have any of these tumbling blocks. And so she was just so kind and thoughtful by taking the time to actually send a shipment. And she got two different kinds because they had the ones with the solid color and then the ones that have the dark and light ones. So I just thought that was so sweet. And then your kind words in a sweet card. So then we have our glue gun, our jute twine, and our scissors. So the first thing we're going to do is cover our little shamrocks, and I took three of those and laid them out. I decided to do it on the back of the shamrocks where it's just solid and no glitter. So I cut out little squares from my scarf, and I wanted to make sure that the squares, since they were pretty big, I wanted them to be in different places on each of the shamrocks so that they didn't look exactly the same. And then I just took my Mod Podge and my makeup sponge and spread that out kind of thinly over the foam and then placed my fabric over the top of it. It's very thin fabric, so you don't want to do what I just did and rub too hard so that it gets crooked. And since there's lines in there, you really notice it if you do get it crooked. And so you just want to start over. It gives you a little bit of time to pick it up and replace it if you do get it out of line. So the next thing we're going to do is paint our frame. And like I said, if you can find a white one, they don't have them very often at the Dollar Tree, but we're going to have to go ahead and paint it, which is fine. So I just took everything out and carefully opened the little tabs that hold the glass in it, because it's a really cheap kind of material. So if you pull them too hard, it could break. So now I'm getting my paper cut down to size, and I just placed the backing of the frame onto it and traced around it and then cut that out. You could do this later, but while my hands are clean before I start painting, I want to do as much as I possibly can. So originally I had planned to have my frame be a darker color, and so I started with the chalk paint in elephant, and then I was going to go back with my Waverly white chalk paint to do the highlights and distressing. After I got that done, I decided I didn't like it that much. I wanted it to be lighter. So I went back in with my white and made that the primary color, and then just let the elephant kind of seep through and blend in so that it was more of the white as the primary color. And that's one reason why I like to paint things, even though I'm not that great at it. You can always change your mind and change the look of something. So if it doesn't turn out the way you originally have in your brain, just keep working with it and change it. While your frame is drying, you can go back, and your Mod Podge should be dry by now. So you can take some small scissors and start cutting around the shamrocks. And the Mod Podge, once it dries, makes the fabric a lot stiffer. And so it's super easy to cut around these little intricate areas. So now that my frame is dry and my shamrocks are all cut out, I'm going to clean off my glass from the inside before I put the paper in there and close it all up. And then again, I'm going to be real careful with the tabs when I close them, making sure I don't break anything. So then after that, I'm going to get my shamrocks ready by placing one of the little tumbling blocks on the back with hot glue, and I put it above the little stem but below the top of the clover so that you can't see it. So then I took some jute twine and tied it in a sweet little bow around the stems of each of the shamrocks. And then I'm going to push a tack into the middle of that bow. And the way I did that was put another tumbling block underneath the shamrock under the stem and then pushed in on the tack until it went into the wood and then picked it up and pushed it all the way through. So then I took a dot of hot glue and put it at the tip of the tack, and then that way when it dried it made a little ball and kept it in place, and then there was no more pokey parts either. Now I'm going to attach my shamrocks to the glass, and so I just put a bead of hot glue down on the tumbling block and placed my center one first, and there's lines in this paper so it was easy to line the shamrocks up straight. And I want the sides to overlap the frames because you guys know I like to overlap things for some reason. And so I just did the first one in the middle and then the two sides so that they would be even. Then to make the bow, I just took a piece of the burlap ribbon and made it cross over in thirds, gathered it in the middle and wrapped my chenille stem around it and twisted it toward the back. And then I'm going to dovetail the edges by folding it over and cutting at a diagonal. I really wanted to make these projects quick and easy, so I didn't make any of the fold over bows, but this way you can do a project in less than 30 minutes and still celebrate the holiday of St. Patrick's Day. And it is a special occasion, and shout out to my Irish friends watching. But St. Patrick is very important to Christianity in that he is considered the apostle to Ireland, just like Paul is the apostle to the Gentiles, the non-Jewish people. He was very important and brought Christianity to Ireland. So then to cover that middle portion of the bow, I cut a little strip from the burlap ribbon and then folded it in thirds and wrapped it around the center and hot glued it together in the middle so it looks like it's actually a tied bow. And then I'm going to take the whole thing and hot glue that to the very top of the frame. And here it is all done, and I love how this turned out. I even really like my paint job, but I'll show this in more detail as we get toward the end when we get everything done. So for our next project, we're going to be doing this potted plant. So for this, we're going to need a black tin bucket. If you can't find one in black, you can paint it, but I got this one at Target Dollar Spot for $1. A tapered piece of floral foam. A package of the St. Patrick's foam scatter. Some green moss. And I got this at Walmart for $2 and some change, but I would have preferred the Dollar Tree kind if I had any. This is just really, really bright. Some plastic greenery, and Dollar Tree carries this as well, and I just got some today. So this is from Walmart, but definitely use the Dollar Tree type. Some wooden skewers, and in this case, these are just leftover scraps. So the first thing we're gonna do is make the little leprechaun belt, and I just cut off a piece of the burlap ribbon and then folded it in half and cut out a little square so that that would be the inside of his belt. And then once I got that done, I'm going to use my little glue dots that I got from Dollar Tree. And I used these before on a project and they didn't work out too well, but this is something that would be perfect for them. And so you just place them onto the surface that you're gluing and then pull off the plastic part after you've already pulled off the paper backing. And then I just put one in all four corners and then attach that to my bucket. And then I'm going to add my floral foam to my bucket. And I think these were made to fit right into things like this and little terracotta pots because it's tapered perfectly. So I just put a bunch of hot glue on top and then put my moss on top of that and just patted it in there until it got into the glue and would stay. And then I take my scissors and kind of give it a haircut so that it's not all the way out of control, but I don't mind some of it hanging over. And then I decided to mix some other greenery in there. So this is a sprig that I had used the flowers from. And so I just cut those down and poked them in here and there. And then I'm going to take my other plastic ones and add those in as well. Now I'm going to take my foam scatter and I'm just going to use the gold coins, and there were four of them in this package. And so using those skewers, I took some hot glue and poured a little bit at the top and then stuck them into the side of the coins. I decided I didn't like the color of the gold. It was a little bit too bright and you can't really tell on film, but I took my gold paint pen and just painted over them and made sure that I tapped on it a few times so that it would get nice and juicy and covered really well, but still kind of kept that glittery look so you could tell it was a gold coin. Then I'm gonna take one of those green foam shamrocks from earlier, and I took some chalk paint, and it's the color moss, and I just covered that completely, and it just took one coat. I'm gonna distress it a little bit, so it really did cover very well, but I'm gonna use this for another pick in the plant. So while that was still wet, I went back in with the color celery and just blended it in and made it darker towards the outside and lighter on the inside. And then I'm gonna go back in a third time, and using my elephant chalk paint, I went around the perimeter of the shamrock and just gave it a shadowy finish. Once the paint was dry, I took that same gold paint pen that I used on the coins and made little shiny lines on the left side of the shamrock. Then I took my gold pieces and started poking them into the plant just randomly at different angles and in different positions. And then I'm going to take my shamrock and hot glue that to a piece of skewer, and I want it to be kind of lopsided peeking out. So I just took that skewer and hot glued it the way I wanted it, and then I'm going to place that back into my plant as well. And then finally, to incorporate a little bit more of the buffalo check into a couple of these pieces, I cut off a little strip from the scarf and then tied that to the handle of the bucket. And you can do this with ribbon or any kind of fabric that you're using, just to give it an extra little touch of your colors. And here it is all done, and I think this turned out really, really cute too. And it's always good to have greenery in a vignette of any type, but I think this is especially appropriate for Valentine's Day. Oh, nope, St. Patrick's Day. Next up, we're going to be making these super cute little wooden blocks, but they're really made out of these foam dice. And I started this craft and was going to use them in a Valentine's Day tutorial, but painted them and then didn't get around to using them. So I'm taking the partially painted dice and finishing them with the moss colored chalk paint, and it took two coats. One thing I do recommend is that you hold on to two sides and then paint the four other sides first, and then do the top or bottom, whatever, and when you set it down, and then wait till all of that dries and then do the last side. Once our blocks are dry, we're going to go in with a black paint pen and make a 1 and a 7 on each of the blocks. So you could use just regular paint and a brush, because these are just simple lines, but I always find that a paint pen is a lot easier and you have more control. Once you get the 1 and the 7 done, I'm going to go in with my paintbrush, and using the color elephant, I'm going to use a very dry brush and go around the edges and just brush that on there to make them look weathered and aged. Now at the top of the blocks, I'm gonna draw a shamrock, and I did that by making three partial hearts that intersect in the middle. And then I'm gonna draw a little stem at the bottom and then fill that all the way in. I'm so sorry my hands are all dirty and icky, but this is part of the crafting process, I guess. And then for the other side, I'm just gonna write St. Patrick and then put another little shamrock underneath that. And here they are all done in all their cuteness. And I went over with a very, very dry brush and just leftover paint to make the black kind of knock down a little bit so that it would match the distressed look of the rest of it. For these last two projects, I'm going to show you how I kind of multitask when I'm making a vignette. I don't do one at a time, I do more than one, and so I go back and forth. So I thought you might be interested to see exactly how I do that. So to start with, I took a board that I had used the front of on a prior project, and it was covered with glitter, so I had to take my Cricut spatula and scratch that all off. And then I took my sanding block and smoothed it out so that it would be a good surface to paint on. Then I used a rag just to wipe off all the sawdust, and then painted the top and the sides with the chalk paint in celery. And then I used a flat and pretty soft brush so that it would have a nice flat finish. And then I'm gonna go back in with my moss colored chalk paint and paint around the edges and make it look darker on the outside and lighter on the inside. I don't know if you've noticed, but I'm showing you a lot more of my messy work area. I had a couple of people say that they wanted to zoom out so that they could see more of what was going on. So let me know if you like it like this. I don't like to see ickies, but if it makes it easier for you, maybe if I went back and forth, because I know some people have a hard time seeing, I know I do, what I'm doing when I'm not zoomed in. So while the paint's drying on my sign, I took the little leprechaun hat and I'm gonna remove the tinsel that is on it. And I put it on a platter so that the little pieces that start kind of falling all over the place aren't everywhere, and I can just throw them away when I'm done. And so I just unwrapped it, and they're wrapped around these little like knobby things that is in the plastic. So I just undid it and just kind of worked it so that it would come off. And if it didn't, you just cut a little snip in it again and keep going. I wanted to get some of those little tabs off of the form, so I just went in with my heavy duty scissors and cut most of them off. Then I separated the two plastic parts of the hat, and then using my elephant chalk paint, I just started dabbing here and there to give it kind of a metal look. And then I'm gonna go back in with my celery and moss green and just give it a distressed look. And this is really a super easy and fast paint technique that you can use on anything to give it that rustic and farmhouse style. So now that that's drying, I'm going to go back in with my sanding block and rough up the edges of my sign. And I like to do a little bit more at the corner so it comes in a little bit further than the rest. So after I'm done sanding, I'm going to wipe off my surface, and then using my same paint pen, I'm going to write in the word Isa Christ. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but that's supposed to be Jesus Christ in Irish. So I just wrote it in regular letters, and then I'm going to go back and do my downstrokes that you know I like to do. And I'll link the video where I do a short handwriting tutorial in the description box below so you can see what I'm talking about. And if you're watching from Ireland, I would love if you would comment and let us know so we can celebrate you as well. So now once I get my letters all done, I'm going to take another one of those shamrocks that we used earlier, and I painted another one, and so I'm going to attach it to the bottom corner of my sign. This was actually an accident. I had made this one for our planter earlier, but I had forgotten to push record on my camera. So that goes to show you that even when you think something is bad, you can always turn it into good. So again, you know how I like things to go over the edge, not in real life, but on my projects. So I made the shamrock go over the side of the board and then hot glued that down and then cut off the bottom so that it could sit straight. I always try really hard not to let any hot glue show in my projects, but sometimes seepage is just gonna happen. So you can always use your utility knife to cut that off and then pull it out. And then I just cut off the edge of the remaining area of the shamrock and then did a little more sanding. And then I took some paint because the bright green was showing where I cut the edges. So I took some more paint and just covered that up. So then finally, I took some more of the Buffalo Check scarf. I folded it in half and then in half again, and then tied a sweet little bow. And I wanted to make sure that there was no raw edges showing in my loops. So I just tucked any that might peek out into the loop itself. And then I cut off the ends at an angle. And then I took some more of the plastic greenery and cut off a couple of sprigs and hot glued that to the bars of the plastic form. And I fed one or two up through the hat so that it would stay in place. And then I took my bow and hot glued that at an angle on the rim as well. And here it is, all done. I placed it on top of a thrifted candle holder that I did in a DIY Trash to Treasure. I will link that video below, but it's a Christmas one, so I don't know if you want to watch that. But if you place it on a candle holder that you have, it's just super cute because it's lifted and you can see everything. So I really love how this turned out. It's celebrating St. Patrick's Day without the screaming loud green. But it's farmhouse, it's rustic, and I love this style. Don't forget to check out the prayer post at the end of this video. We're heading into Lenten season, and so part of that is prayer. And so we are going to be praying for all of you guys fervently, and I hope everybody has a blessed day. And remember to always be the light. Bye.